What is going on, guys? BCD here, and today I want to bring you a quick video. Basically, what I want to go over is my experience with the Samsung Galaxy S9, my thoughts on it, and what I think about it, essentially. So, as I've been playing with it for the last couple of days here, I haven't had it for long, but I can give you like a opinion on how I feel about the phone, what I like about it, what I don't like about it, and whether or not I'm going to decide to switch from the Pixel 2 XL to this phone. So starting off with my just in first impressions out of the box experience, of course the screen is great. You already know that. Only thing that you probably don't know about the phone is that the battery is not as great as it should be. I feel like that's something that they did because of the explosions and stuff like that. I feel like they dialed that back so it does not stay alive or charge as long as the Pixel 2 XL, and it just really doesn't compare. It's not like it's terrible, it's just not the greatest battery experience. So be aware of that, because if you're someone that's conscious about how long you have your phone out, whether or not you take long trips or do stuff like where you don't really charge up only at the end of the day, this might not be the best phone, but it definitely can fit your lifestyle because it has so many options with Samsung's power usage that you can extend it by just putting on power savings mode, changing some of your settings, things like that, the resolution even. It's a lot of things you can do to make it last longer, so I'm okay with the battery now. So I usually get around 6 hours of on-screen time while just doing crap, not really doing anything special on it. It's just that I, you know, watch videos, sometimes play games, stream music, checking different applications and stuff like that. So it's just more of me just always using the phone when I'm at work, during downtime, just chilling at home, stuff like that. So it is a good phone. It's great media consumption because of the, you know, unibody style edge to edge screen. Another great thing about it, which I already stated, is that screen. It is a really impressive screen on a smart device. It really pops. The colors are great. I did not notice how, you know, muted the Pixel 2 XL's colors were until I actually sat them up against each other. I mean, of course, I can turn on the saturated, but it was just mind-boggling how different everything looked. I guess you don't know until you know, and then at that point, you really can't go back. So that's pretty much at a point I'm at with the Pixel 2 XL, because what I didn't know is that how bad it was. Now that I do know, I don't think I can pretty much go back to that screen without changing some of the settings around, or at least, you know, stop looking at the Samsung screen. Another thing that I really enjoyed about the phone is like all the customization. Of course, it's Android, so Google has that too. But I feel like Samsung has their own little, you know, stuff. Even though I hate everything about it, immediately closed off Bixby, tried it for like 2 seconds, sucked, turned off the button, did a bunch of things that probably would not make it look like a Samsung phone anymore, but I did like some of the features. I like the edge-to-edge. I like some of their actual battery-saving utensils. I like some of their actual app drawer more than I like the regular Google one. So some things I prefer, others I don't. I turn off everything I don't like, which I'm glad they give you the option to. I just wish they would let me, you know, change that Bixby button to Google Assistant, because I use that a lot and I really miss my Edge activation on the Pixel 2 XL. So that's something I've been missing. Another pro for the Samsung, in my opinion, is not the camera, but the video quality. It can shoot up to 60 frames per second. Video stabilization sucks. I can't say that it's good, but I can't say that it is as good as the Pixels. But I can say that it shoots a little bit better, and it's like it's more clearer for me, in my opinion, how when I am shooting little small videos or something like that, I prefer the Samsung's video camera over the Pixels, but I prefer the Pixels camera over the Samsung. Samsung seems to always blow out some little detail or something like that, or it's like a little bit oversaturated, but I feel like the Pixel just does a really good job of sharpening everything in the picture, making it look perfect when that processing after. So that's something I really got to, live with. I'm not sure if you can tell by the way my tone is now, but I did switch over to the Samsung. I'm more than likely going to get rid of my Pixel. Yeah, that's pretty much going to happen. But I enjoyed that Pixel. I'd still enjoy it. I feel like it's a great phone. I just feel like the Samsung, is a better experience for now. I think the Pixel, it was always, I felt like I was a beta tester for them for some reason. It was just sometimes you had these small quirks and I just didn't like it. Samsung, I'm sure probably going to sure be a beta tester for, but they get more time to, get to the updates that Google's pushing out. Because that is just, pure Android, and I feel like pure Android will be the most optimized portion of it. But at sometimes I just don't feel like it works as well as others. So right now I'm enjoying my Samsung. Still have both phones. Don't know if I'm gonna either sell it or keep it, but right now my daily driver is the Samsung for those reasons. The screen, the videography, and the I wouldn't say it's more stable. I can't say that it's more stable. I just know, in my personal opinion, using it, maybe because it's just a newer phone, but because I've been using it more frequently now versus my Pixel and comparing everything together, it really does feel like the more stable version at the moment. Probably, with TouchWiz on top of it, might bog down. Who knows? But right now, I'm enjoying the experience. I broke it pretty much down to pure Android, took everything I didn't want from Samsung, kept the stuff that I wanted, and I am enjoying my experience as of now. Battery is the only thing I'm scared about, so moving forward, I'm gonna keep reporting on that, but right now, all good. Yeah, but that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this commentary, don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one. Peace.